What's up guys, and this is it. Some of the final iPhone 12 leaks are here, starting with the bombshell news of them all. 120Hz is 99% confirmed that it's not happening. As reported by John Prosser on Twitter, 120Hz codename D6X didn't make mass production. Now you can give up. It's not just him, other people have said this as well. I guess that pretty much seals the deal for most people, especially those who are using last year's iPhone 11 series, because 120Hz is one of the prime features on smartphone these days. It's a pro feature that almost all Android phones have, so Apple fans, you have to wait another year to get 120Hz. Now to be fair, Apple is famous for their optimization, they're famous for delivering a smooth experience, like literally, they were the first one to properly introduce a swipe gesture system on a modern smartphone, and the way they did it was completely amazing. Since the launch of these gestures with the iPhone X, things have been incredibly smooth, and they still are really smooth. The iPhone 11 series is incredibly fast, incredibly optimized. It's pretty clear that Apple is not the best when it comes to smartphone design innovations or features in certain area like higher refresh rate. But the main question is, how many people actually care about 120Hz? That is something that only the sales will answer, but one thing for certain is that the Pro series is starting to look less and less exciting. With the lack of 120Hz, the non-Pro iPhone 12 and the iPhone 12 Plus model will definitely be the most popular iPhone 12 models in the series. As always, 120Hz or not, Apple is bringing some insane, incredible price value with a starting price of $699 on the iPhone 12 5.4-inch model, and then rumored $750 starting price for the iPhone 12 Plus model, and then $1,000 for the Pros. Now, as reported earlier, the iPhone 12 series is indeed in mass production. According to John, the out-of-the-box software for the iPhone 12 will be iOS 14.1. It will be completed on 10th October, so pretty much it's impossible for Apple to announce the iPhone 12 on September 15th event, but there's always that element of surprise. As always, never say never, but I do believe that the iPhone 12 lineup will most likely happen in the month of October. Now, Philip has what I think the most accurate iPhone 12 Pro 3D model. He posted this picture on Twitter, so be on the lookout for his video. Now, speaking of the models, these are probably the finalized parts of the camera regarding the iPhone 12 series. So you can see the 5.4-inch iPhone 12 and the 6.1-inch iPhone 12 Plus. They both are missing the LiDAR sensor, but they will be having the two main cameras similar as the Pro series, which is what most people care about. Ultra-wide-angle lens and that 7P 12 megapixel lens. And then we have the 12 Pro and the 12 Pro Max. You can see the LiDAR sensor. And if you actually pay attention to the 12 Pro Max camera module, it seems like it has a bigger cutout for the camera. Again, I'm really interested to see if there's any specific changes to the Pro Max model. Also, EvLeaks has tweeted out some details of the iPhone 12, which pretty much confirms that the iPhone 12 series is indeed coming in the month of October. Not only this, it also confirms the full-on 5G implementation on the whole iPhone 12 lineup. According to this leak, the pre-order ends 20th October, so very likely that the iPhone 12 series won't be coming on September 15th, which means we're gonna see the Apple Watch Series 6 and iPad Air 4 plus some other products. According to John, Apple is planning a cheaper version of Apple Watch, aka Apple Watch SE or Apple Watch Special Edition. As the name suggests, just like the iPhone SE is gonna be the cheaper budget model of the Apple Watch series, and it might get announced alongside with the brand new Apple Watch Series 6. But interestingly, he mentioned that there might be some changes to the naming. Apple might introduce these watches as Apple Watch Pro and the Apple Watch, kind of like the iPhones, you know, simplifying the names. Again, this may or may not happen. This is how things are listed. By the way, the text of the actual live stream shows the Series 6 text, which probably confirms that Series 6 is 100% happening. All in all, the event is looking exciting because there is that element of surprise, but honestly, the future of Apple is looking even more incredible. The foldable iPhone / foldable iPad era is finally coming. Apple has placed huge number of orders for foldable displays from Samsung, as reported by iCineverse. He says that it is meant for testing purposes, which means that Apple has finally set their eyes on the foldable game considering how overpowered Samsung is right now. The Fold 2 is amazing, and right now it is untouchable. As much as I love it, I'm really interested to see a foldable iPhone or foldable iPad in the future. Will it run iOS or iPad OS? So many questions, but I really want to see how Apple does their foldable thing. Now, it's not just the iPhones. Apple is also actively working hard to get rid of this notch while still retaining the 3D Face ID. According to iCineverse, the notch might get erased completely on the iPhone 13 next year. Again, that's a guess, but considering the recent orders of foldable displays, it seems like Apple is pretty serious about it. As of now, the notch stays on the iPhone 12. We're gonna see a brand new boxy premium design like the iPhone 5. It's gonna feel super premium in hand. Also, 7P lens that iPhone 12 models are using are actually a big deal because it's gonna improve the image quality a lot, especially in low light situation. It's now been reported that many Android manufacturers could follow this move and implement 7P lens in their flagship phones as well. Honestly, the camera gains on the iPhone 12 are looking pretty sweet. We've got 4K 240fps video support along with 4K 120fps, enhanced night mode, depth video for the first time, LiDAR scanner for autofocus, enhanced bokeh. It might actually be a noticeable jump from the iPhone 11 series, especially in low light and in extreme night mode scenarios. Now, speaking of next year, it seems like Apple has sealed the deal with BOE OLED displays exclusively for the iPhone 13 lineup. It's reported by this French website which says that BOE has received new orders with the codename B11. This may be for cheaper iPhone models next year. Now, as we know, Uncle Timmy is the one that runs the game at Apple, and his retirement days are not that far. So it's been reported on Bloomberg that the next CEO of Apple could be the chief operating officer Jeff Williams, aka Tim Cook Pro. It seems like Apple is thinking of making more younger generation of CEOs that can lead the way. Very excited to see what's the next big move in the company. So that's all the news. I have to say, this is it. 120Hz is not happening. iPhone 12 models are pretty much confirmed to happen in October, but still, there is that 1% element of surprise on September 15th, which makes everything exciting. Apple Watch SE, Apple Watch Series 6, along with iPad Air 4, plus some other exciting stuff coming on September 15th event. Super excited. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.